Good evening, everybody. I'm going to do an official welcome later on in the program, but I just wanted to point out right now that there was a reversal in the order of the program. The first piece we started with tonight was The Magician and not Viper. So I'm sure many of the people in the audience, after looking at the program, were saying, that doesn't sound very Viper-ish to me. It sounded more Magician-ish. You are absolutely right. Okay, so well done, and you should trust your instincts throughout the whole night. I think the rest of the program is pretty much in the same order, so it shouldn't be that tricky. But congratulations if that's what you were thinking the whole time. Yeah, it really doesn't sound Viper-ish to me. The last piece on this program for these guys sounds very Viper-ish because it's called Viper. And that's why. So, thank you.
Thank you. any luck, this next piece will sound very viperish. And in case the title would imply that Viper the Snake, it's actually an F-16 training program that they have down in the United States. So you'll hear during this a couple of quotes of America, which is stolen from the English God Save the Queen. So you'll hear that throughout as sort of patriotic. The United States tend to be a little patriotic about things. So they'll cram that into any piece of music that they can possibly find, even one of both F-16 fighter jets, which they're also very, very excited about down in the United States. So this is the last piece of the Red Band. This group is really, both great dime bands have really, really come along. I think if you notice since September, or since the last concert, certainly since September. And it's been really, really great working with them. Next year, we're going to combine them into a grade 10 band. And I'm really, really, really looking forward to their next step. The next step between grade 9 and 10 is very extreme, actually. And many of them, when they see the music in September, get, well, we can't do that, but they'll do it, and they'll do a great job with it.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah, nice. Official welcome. Thank you very much for coming to Concert Night. I know I'm sick, and pretty much everyone at Richmond Hill is sick. I know in the school it is, so it's amazing that we're all here just in general. That's one thing to be thankful for, and certainly thankful that you guys have come tonight. You know, a beautiful day today. It's always nice to have a good weather when we're loading up the truck and coming over. We're hoping that tomorrow's going to be the same, but it's coming, and it's a great time to have a spring showcase, I think. So we've got, if you were here for our fall showcase, you know what to expect, you expect to hear some great things tonight, and that's what we've prepared for you. I do want to, just as we're opening up, I will say as little as possible. We'll keep the show moving on a musical theme, but just again, at the beginning, I just want to sort of mention a couple things. Number one, you know, regarding cell phones, if we can make sure that they're turned off, unless they're in the approved key, and if they're going to ring, if they ring in key, then that's okay. And what we'll do is maybe we'll tell you before each piece what key it's in, and then you can make the adjustments as necessary. I would say, too, in terms of our philosophy of our department is one of collaboration, and the root of that is the fact that tonight and tomorrow night, we're going to be putting 400 students across the stage, and we have been talking about it in terms of it is 400 students working on one event for several months, and we appreciate your support by buying tickets and being here. We do ask, and no, there's no chains on the doors, and we have no snipers preventing you from leaving, but we do ask that you do stay for the entire show to support all of the students as part of the performance. I know it's very easy to say, well, that was it, my kid's done now. It's part of it. If we had this place for every single band and just had like a 20-minute or 30-minute show, it would be very, very, very expensive. As it is very expensive, we want to make sure you get the most out of it. So especially the grade 9 parents, I think it's kind of exciting to see where the students will be going in the next couple of years. So we hope you do take part in that and share the performance. Again, I know there are sure, don't judge people too, because I know some people are running off now to go to volleyball games and things like that. So don't you know, shun them or attendance shame people. We are forgiving. We just want to make sure people understand that, I think we're in good shape. I'll mention too, before the Black Band comes on, when I mentioned that the piece Viper is, yes, about an F-16 fighter program, but it doesn't actually quote America. That theme right there. That is actually the Black Band. I get the two of them confused very much simply because I'm old and stupid. That's their last piece, which is called Escape from the Deep. And I'll talk about that when we get them on stage. Anyway, we're going to hear from, I think we have some performers over the side here. I think, is it Lucy and Ben that are going to perform for us right now?
Hi.
Hi, is that Lucy and Ben?
Yeah.
Okay, we're going to get some lights on you. There you are. This is the ukulele one. Oh. Sorry about that. No, I love the lead ukulele. It's so cute. Okay. Be cute and smile lots. Okay. Attention that way.
I'm Ben.
I'm Lucy.
We're grade 12 and we'll be singing Have You Ever Seen the Rain?
Yeah.
When it's over, so they say,
Again, for the observant people in the audience, not that you aren't all observant, but I know sometimes after a long day, you know, the energy levels and whatnot, you kind of nod off. I always tell the students you have to make sure that you get the beginning and the end really, really strong, because chances are half the audience is asleep no matter what, in the middle part anyway. And that is not a reflection on the performers. I know myself, when I've gone to see the Toronto Symphony sometimes, I have been known to let my, well, resting my eyes is the older way of saying it. That's what the older guys always say, resting their eyes, okay? But if you've noticed, the way we put our program together sometimes, there is a pattern to it. And what one thing we've had an opportunity to do with the grade 9s this year is expose them to a little bit of Broadway music. So I don't know if any of you are familiar with the Music Man that the Red Band played. It's a very classic Broadway musical, and we're going to play All That Jazz and All That Jazz from the Broadway musical Chicago. Is this one, Escape from the Deep, All the titles have some sort of meaning. And I guess, you know, sometimes it's fun to know the background, sometimes it's great to imagine your own. This was actually written to commemorate a naval disaster, actually, a bunch of submarine crew who lost almost everyone but four people managed to survive a mishap, a training accident. And this is basically dedicated to that. So again, that's why this will have some patriotic flair into it that you will notice, and because I've mentioned so much about it. Okay, so I hope you guys really enjoy this piece. This is a really difficult piece. There's a lot of different stuff in this, and it really is great to transition again these guys into next year and make that transition a little easier for them. So I'm really, really happy. At one point we were wondering, you know, I don't know if we can play this one, but especially later on as the piece goes, they really, really pick it up, and it's a great piece to play, and we certainly hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Boy, the audience got a lot more lively all of a sudden. I think you guys got some extra help from the upstairs there. They're doing a good job. I remember a lesson of how, and don't take this the wrong way, that they, you know, just join in with their enthusiasm, because I remember this lesson. We did a tour of Boston a number of years ago. We brought about 150 kids to Boston. We did several great performances. We did this great performance at Harvard, at Harvard University, in this theater that they never let out to the public, but I knew some people, and we got in and we had this great workshop and concert with the dean of the Boston Conservatory. It was a wonderful experience. And I remember one of the concerts we had was in this tiny church, and I had not set it up, our travel agent had set it up. And when we got there, I mean, one of our groups was like 100 students. And when we got there, I was really, really surprised and shocked to see how small the place was. And it was one of those things that could have turned into this disaster really fast. But we sort of grouped together and we figured out a way that we could fit all the students in this one place. The audience, when it showed up, there were only about 30 people in the audience. So we had 100 people on stage at one point and 30 people in the audience. But here's the thing, they were such a loud audience, not during the performance, okay? Not while they were performing, but after each performance, they were really, really into it. And we were doing this sort of guess the song piece, and I remember one of the pieces we did was this, the theme from Zorro. And I turned around to see if anyone was guessing it. One person stood up and started going like this during the middle of the performance. But I remember this for myself, to be a good audience, because after the concert, we had such a warm response from them. Actually, some of our students were really moved. They were actually, some of them were in tears. And they said, they love us more than our parents do. And I said, no, they're just not as tired of you as they are. So I had their back, the parents' back a little bit. But it was wonderful to see how performers react to an audience. The one thing being, you know, respectful to listen. Okay, we have the best of both worlds. And also very energetic with the applause. It really, really does help. So we're going to move on right now. Sophia is going to introduce, I think Sophia's over there. Are you over there, Sophia? There she is. So she doesn't have a ukulele, but I guess, you know, the flute's kind of cute as well. Are you going to introduce what you're going to play?
Can people
hear me? Well, if you move closer to the microphone, they can. Well, if you move closer to the microphone, it'll work. Yes, yeah, that works. She's a flute player. She's, you know. Ooh, shots fired.
So what I'm going to be playing today is the first movement from Widor's suite for flute and piano. But I don't have a piano accompanist with me today, so it's just going to be me. That's okay. Hopefully it'll turn out well.
Thank you.
to introduce to you some people from the school council. The school council, you guys can start coming up if you want. The school council is a group of mostly parents that work very, very, very hard to represent the school the best they possibly can, doing all sorts of different things that today we'll talk about. I'm a member of that, and they put up with me very well, and they say nice things about me to my face. I don't know what's going on when I miss a meeting. That's why I never like missing meetings, because two things, you don't know what they're going to say about you, and then you get signed up to do other things. So you always want to make sure you go to all the meetings, but we have, yeah. I'll let you guys take the mic.
Thank you, Mr. Horner. We always enjoy the concert that the music department performs. Hello, everyone. Hi. My name is Philip.
And I'm Patricia.
Yeah, we are from the Bayview School Council, and we are here to let you know that we work hard. We work really hard for you and for all the students. And the parents, too.
Our goal is to provide advice on school matters and strengthen the important relationship between schools, parents, and our communities. Together, we work for the improvement of students' well-being and academic success.
Each year, school council provides support to Bayview, such as facility upgrade, including the 10 new bicycle racks, and the school also purchased another 10. And we also provide awards to students, student achievement awards and staff appreciation. Financial support, we sponsor healthy snack program for hungry students. And Relay for Life for fundraising for the cancer research. And also we support cameras for visual arts department and also other programs.
In addition, we offer workshops to parents so that we can be better companions to our children. Workshops that we have offered this year, Cyber World and NetAware, When to Worry, When Not to Worry. If you missed these two workshops, our next workshop, Parent Symposium, on Thursday, April the 27th at 7 p.m. Please join us for this workshop. Let's hear from the youth to speak about their high school anxiety, bullying, and the stress about being perfectionists. Workshop two will be about brain fitness, which is managing stress for parents and students. For more information, we invite you to please come out to the foyer tonight. We have a table set up there. We'd be happy to answer any questions you may have. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Congratulations. One more time for the conductors of the string ensemble.
Second half of the evening, we're going to start with our Bayview Secondary School Concert Choir. We meet very early in the morning, 7:30. I'm sure some of the parents know they've woken up extra early to drop kids off twice a week. And for being such early, everyone shows up and is awesome and excited in the morning. We have quite a few pieces to do tonight. The first one is called Dee Ray Tom. It is in French, so I'm going to read the translation. So they say, abandon enveloping abandon, tenderness brushing tenderness, who you are sustains you, eternally so they say. Your very being is nourished by its own enlightened reflection, so you compose the theme of Narcissus Redeemed.
Thank you. sitting all alone, feeding her fawn into the mountainside. Phyllis, I saw sitting all alone, feeding her fawn into the mountainside. Shadows should not be enough, but she was gone, you know, but she was gone.
Voices, all the voices, lift your heart. With musical instruments, we will sing of freedom and love. Make harmony, let's go sing and play, all voices, all people, capably with all voices, with instruments, with hope, and with rhythm. Clap your hands to the rhythm, clap your hands with all the people, with all voices, with happiness, and with joy. We will sing with joy, with love, and hope. We will sing of peace, we will sing of love. We will sing with happiness and with joy, rhythm. This is Ritmo.
embracing the philosophy that every single performance in our rehearsals is a performance, and it's something that, you know, if you've ever played an ensemble before, you know, when we're playing together with about 60 people, it is, you know, rare sometimes that everything clicks perfectly. It's usually pretty good, but sometimes it just, you know, really, really clicks well. And we look forward to those in rehearsal just as much as on the stage. So that is something that you are supporting as well. That's really important. It looks like we actually do have marimba players up here now, do we? Okay, so I'll thank some other people later on, but let's thank the parents of Jacob and Ian for getting them here and on stage and taking away. What are you going to play? Are you going to introduce it? Hmm? You're playing Zelda? What's Zelda? Well, I do want to hear, but I want to hear what we're hearing. What's Zelda? It's just called Zelda. Is Zelda not a video game? Oh, so this is the music from a video game.
Yeah.
Ah, there we go. Okay, there, that word, the mystery is unraveling now. Okay, so this is what we would hear during the video game. In four different video games, so for all the same price. Yeah, okay, that's great. All right, this is a bargain. You guys are getting 4-for-1 here. Okay, 4-for-1, Zelda, take it away, boys. Thank you.
Yeah. sing you all these to wear that bar and chain.
It's kind of like a symphony, and it's very, the last movement in particular, if anyone is a classical music fan, you'll get this. It sounds very much like Utterino Respighi's Pines of Rome, if anyone knows that. It is based on that, so it's based on some very, very, very serious classical music, and a very, very challenging piece, so we're looking forward to that. Thank you. when we're looking at the Great Nines, where I'm looking at the Great Nines during rehearsals, some of the things that I'm always doing is I'm always thinking, you know, 3 years from now, what are they going to be playing when they're in grade 12, and it's or grade 11 in this case. It's really exciting when they get to that point because they've had to make so many sacrifices to be there. For our school to have a grade 11 ensemble this large is really, really quite an accomplishment. So just, again, like I was kidding around with, you know, everyone being sick, it's amazing that we're all here. But it really is amazing that these main students have chosen to sacrifice so much time to learn their instruments proficiently, and as the reward, they get to challenge themselves with some really, really interesting music. We spend a lot of time making sure that the music that we select is something that's interesting to them and to an audience. When we get to pieces like the Suite Divertimento, it really is a challenge. That's a real, you know, substantial piece of music for them to be able to tackle is a real accomplishment, and it's something that started, you know, many years ago. And when I was looking, you know, watching them play, I was thinking, okay, I think they could handle this because we've got, you know, a great French horn section for one thing, and we've got you know, the members that can do this. So it really is exciting to see this for me, you know, in to get to this point. And even more so next year. I've talked to them already about some of the pieces we're going to be playing next year with the Grade 12 band. So it's really, really, really exciting. So we did not get a chance to do too many thank yous because things were moving fairly smoothly here. And I'm going to do quickly because, again, it is a collaborative thing, and there's so many small little things that people do that make a big effort on this one that the thank yous are important, but we're going to miss people. It's absolutely true. So I would like to thank the help of the Richmond Hill Center for the Performing Arts. I came in earlier today and I had a migraine and I was able to do very, very little, and they took over and did so many things that we're used to working with the crew here, and it's a fantastic group. If you don't come and watch some of the other performances that go on and support this theater, you're really missing out on something. This is probably the best theater, if not in Toronto, outside of the Toronto area. They invested very well in this theater. There's not a bad seat in the house. And they do a great job of bringing in some really, really interesting performers. I know it seems like a hassle to get out of the house, the band cave, you know, that has the, you know, all the 70-foot screen, no, not 70-foot, that's too big, is it? 70-inch TV screens and whatnot. But, you know, and I know that the expense seems like maybe not, you know, it's too much, but it's not. It's always a great experience to see what live music, and you should really think about supporting that. I'm going to thank the students, because again, they are now at a point with this, the Music Council anyway, is at a point where they really, I could not even show up, and I know you know it. Now they're starting to conduct. I'm not sure if I'm going to have a job much longer because they could literally just do this on their own. We had our music banquet last year. I don't know why I keep on timing these migraines this way, and I couldn't make it, but they just, you know, ran and organized everything. And it was fantastic to see that. Okay, so thank you for everyone coming out. Thank you for supporting, and thank you to the students. We're gonna have we have a chance to have a little bit of fun with this last piece. The music department likes dragons, so this is the ode to the dragons. And has anyone seen that movie before? Not Ode to the Dragons, How to Train Your Dragon, has anyone seen that? It wasn't a documentary. I know a lot of people said that, oh, I'm not watching that. It sounds like too much work. No, it was a great movie. Did you like it? You were kind of going like this. Or are you really excited about dragons? No? Oh, yes. Okay, so there we go. We've got at least one person who's going like this. Okay. Thank you very much. Like I said, right after the concert, the good news on tonight is that we are here for two nights. And if you want to come back the second night, we can talk about ticket prices and stuff like that. But it's a great class. We have a guest soloist touring, playing a clarinet concerto, which is fantastic. It's really, really, really something to see. But give me an email, I'll set you up, I'll get you some good seats. But tonight, we don't have to do much of any cleaning up, so you don't have to stay here, you don't have to go home, but you can't stay here. We're going to kick you right out of the door. You don't even have to wait for us to clean up today. So I know some people are already, let's go start the car. But we're going to do this one, and you guys, thank you very much. Make sure you don't leave anything here, but you don't have to. There's nothing that needs to be cleaned up here. Make sure everything is cleaned up upstairs, and that's it. Okay, that's the technical stuff. Now we'll get to have fun.